Don't have to leave this town to see the world, 'cause it's something that I gotta do. I don't wanna look back in 30 years and wonder who you're married to. Wanna say it now, wanna make it clear for only you and God to hear. When you love someone, they say you set them free, but that ain't gonna work for me.
From a lonely screen, where we drink up. teaches us that in the very beginning of time, that God spoke with words and created the earth, created the stars, the sky, and all that was there. Then the Bible tells us that God created man. And in Genesis 3, we read that God created man in his own image. And Adam was given a job. Adam's job was to work in the garden and to name all of the animals and all of these things. And as Adam was doing a phenomenal job, God said, it's not good that man should be alone. So I want to make for him a helpmate. God caused a deep sleep to come upon Adam. And while he was asleep, God took one of his ribs and created a woman. Now, there's something special about a woman. A woman is the only thing in all of creation that was not created from the dirt. A woman was created from man. And that's why, ladies and gentlemen, we treat women better than ourselves. We don't treat women like dirt because they weren't made from dirt. After Eve was created, God Almighty himself brought Eve to Adam. And Adam said, just in the tone of the song that we just heard, wow, this is flesh of my flesh. This is bone of my bone. And the Bible says that Adam took Eve to be his wife. So into this union, Shayne and Becky have come to be married today. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Our family and I.
Amen. When we talk of marriage, when we talk of couples, a lot of things go on in life. But what God has created is marriage, as husband and wife, is for always. It's for eternity. And so you guys are coming together today to pledge your love to each other, not just for a season, but for the rest of your days. And what a refreshing thing it is to know that God loves us eternally. And God looks at our past and we see things that have happened in our past. And God says, you know what? We can get past the past. And we can have a life going forward. And that's why you guys are here today. And so, Shayne, do you take this woman to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward? And do you promise to love her and cherish her and care for her for the rest of your life? And Becky, do you take Shayne to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward? For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer? Do you promise to love him and care for him for the rest of your life? When we think about all that's going on today, in just a moment we're going to exchange rings. And the beautiful thing about a ring is that it never ends. You take just a ring and it's just a circular shape. You can't tell where it starts or where it ends or what it's been through. All you see is the beauty of it. And in the end of your days, your family's going to look back and say, remember June 20th, 2020? That was the start of a beautiful life for a beautiful couple. God is going to bless you in your life as long as you stay faithful to him. The Bible teaches us, and we've talked about all of these things, but the Bible teaches us in the book of Ephesians that a man is to love his wife as God loves the church. Now, how does God love the church? With everything that he's got. God created the church. He loves the church. God considers the church to be his bride. And in that same scripture, God says, well, we give our bride everything we can. We give them the greatest adornment. We give them all that they want to make them beautiful, not just for the world to see, but God makes the church beautiful for him. And so you pour yourself into your wife to make her life beautiful for you. And when we go back to Genesis, God said, I want to make Adam a helpmate. I want to make someone that's going to make his life better. And that's what you're supposed to do. We talk about this word, and a lot of people get upset because we use the word submissive, right? But we've talked about what that means. It doesn't mean that Shayne gets to sit in his chair and rattle his glass and you jump up and go get him some tea, right? That's not submissive. Being submissive is loving, it's respectful. respectful, it's being kind, it's being the helpmate that God has called you to be. So do we have the rings? So what I want you to do is place the ring on her right ring finger, her left ring finger.
Yes.
I'm backwards most of the time, guys. I'm supposed to know that, right? And I want you to say this with me. Becky, with this ring, I give way. I pledge to love you and honor you and cherish you just as God loves the church for the rest of my life. Now, Becky, I want you to place the ring on his finger. And I want you to repeat after me. Shayne, I promise to love you for the rest of my life. I promise to honor you. I promise to care for you. I promise to cherish you. And with this ring, I pledge you my love. With the vows being exchanged, the rings being exchanged, in the sight of God and all of these great witnesses, Shayne, you may kiss your bride.
Forever getting ready, so she's never on time for anything. When she gets that come get me look in her eyes, well, it kinda scares me the way that she drives me wild. And she drives me wild. There was something about that kiss about you. I would be lying.
You guys just jump in and photobomb it, so it'll be fun, okay? So, 1, 2, 3, photobomb.
Okay,
look
I lost
here.
Your face.
Kyrie.
What's your name? What's her name?
Kyrie.
Can
you
see on the other side?
I
look at
the other side.
Because I'm right-handed.
Yeah, it makes you feel more comfortable petting that way. Mm-hmm.